1971, Steven Spielberg makes his directorial debut with the movie Duel. David Mann is an unsuspecting salesman who passes the wrong vehicle, a menacing Peterbilt that soon unleashes hell on the highway.
This is what it takes for the 50th anniversary of Duel. We gotta scout out the locations, figure out where we're gonna set everything, get the fires ready, and it just so happens that the Duel truck is flammable!
All right, here's what we're doing. We're gonna pretend that we're the fire marshal. We're just, as my grandma used to say, an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. We're gonna contain the fire in the barrels, so we'll do it nice and safe. Plus, we can stage it to look sort of Mad Max style.
It is gonna get real cold.
Yeah, it drops quick. You can already feel it.
Let me show you how cool this is. You never get to see the menacing driver inside of Duel. Step forward. Where is he?
Burn it for the anniversary of Duel, and why not? Because Duel needs to have flames. We're talking hell on the highway, right? I mean, this truck right here is Hollywood royalty. Brad has owned the last truck or vehicle from the movie Duel for the last 12, 13, going on
since 2009.
13 years.
Yeah.
Isn't that ironic?
13.
Here it is, November 13th, 2021, marking the 50th anniversary of
Duel. And my 13th year of owning a truck.
And the 13th year that you own it. So what we want to do is raise a glass to Spielberg and what he's done, and certainly Kerry Lofton, the man. That rig right there and what they did in 1971, 50 years ago today, is still resonating, and we are here celebrating it the only way that we know how, which is at Brad's place, smoke and mirror style. And what do we call ourselves? I don't know. Losers? Okay. That's okay, there's a test.
Fifty years have passed, and the hell has only gotten higher.
I can't see anything.
Oh my God, my finger's burning.
So Brad was saying that Chris and Jerry came from Canada to do the photogrammetry of the Duel rig to turn it into an NFT. Now, if you don't know what an NFT is, it's a non-fungible token. They're all the rage right now. They're crazy. In fact, 100 million people have searched for NFTs. 100 million people. So they're curious, very curious, what NFTs are. Well, we're ahead of the game because in the summer, a couple months ago, we had the guys come down from Canada to do the photogrammetry and turning that truck into the NFT.
We're wrapping up the final day of the shoot for the MoxieToken.com Duel NFT, non-fungible token. If you don't know what that is and you like collectibles, this is your kind of a tip. Follow us, moxietoken.com. That beast of an analog rig is now being completely digitized far beyond the lens of this camera in front of me and far beyond the TV screen that you're watching this through. It's going into the stratosphere of digital world called the NFT, non-fungible token. It will be on the marketplace. I guarantee you that you will never have another one like it. There's only gonna be one. If you have a dollar, I don't know, maybe that will buy it. If you have $10 million, maybe that will buy it.
That's the original truck. But the Duel NFT truck, minted in 2021, celebrated right now on the 50th anniversary, all part of the Duel NFT. MoxieToken.com.
But they were dedicated, and they went and searched and researched and did this stuff. I think the production that they've came up with is going to be really interesting.
Let's go right now if we can. I'm going to see if I can get on the phone. We'll take a break. I'm going to see if I can get the UK guys. I'm going to see if I can get Roger from the Devil on Wheels film to live stream with us right now.
How are you? My name is Andre. How are you?
When you all four got to Brad Wike's place on Blackburn Bridge Road in North Carolina, what were you thinking when you actually were beholding the actual rig?
Yeah, we were just like, oh my God, there it is. You know, we just drove in front of it, and it was kind of overshadowing. It's like,
gobsmacked.
There we were. It's like, this is impossible. Is this real? And then we came out, and it was so much going on at that moment. And then we decided to set up the interview right there. Like, okay, we do the interview right there with the truck and the car, and then, you know, and everything started rolling. But that day was incredible.
Yeah, because that was April the 9th, 2016, which also happens to be Enric's birthday.
It's true, it was my birthday. So it was one of the best birthdays of my life, to be honest. Right. Because obviously, Brad treat me like a king. I tried, you know, he treats everyone like a king all the time. Yeah. But in that case, it especially so. He took me around with the truck. He let me do anything I wanted. You know, I was like a kid, you know, thinking like in Wonderland, saying this is a dual truck, and this is a dual car, although the dual car is a replica, but still getting on top of the dual truck, chasing the dual car. When Spielberg picked up this truck, I mean, think of the truck as an actor, because he was looking for a character. The truck becomes a character. So he was choosing the truck by the same rules you choose an actor, right? Because of the look, the presence, the personality. And then he chose this one. As far as I know, he didn't have many choices, but he had three or four. The other trucks seem to be pretty standard trucks. And there's this old butter one is the one that stole his heart. If we get a Spielberg, we'll put it at the end. But the film is finished, completely locked now. We just need to solve this problem to be able to show it. That's what we're fighting for, okay, at the moment. So, if anyone is willing to help, you know, please do.
where we go to the devilonwheelsmovie.com, is that correct?
That is correct.
It goes to their website, and then there's explains how you can help. And in return, people will place their name in our film. So,
awesome!
Yeah, exactly.
So you make a donation, you get your name in the credits as one of the contributors.
Exactly.
That's right.
The bigger donation, the bigger your name will be.
Thank you, Overdrive, for putting us in the 50th anniversary. It's a very special date for us. It's so great someone is helping to make this known. I mean, thanks a lot, Overdrive. Thank you.
Thank you, Overdrive. Thanks for the chance to be with you in this, the 50th anniversary of this amazing little masterpiece, which is Duel. Thank you.
Thank you, Overdrive.
Yeah, thanks, truck drivers. Let's bring this story back to where it should be.
You guys think it's appropriate that we're toasting marshmallows in flames next to the Duel rig for the 50th anniversary?
It does say it's inflammable, but hey, you guys are for those things, you know. Well, I'd like to come and have some marshmallows with you guys and screen it outdoor.
Well, we won the truck at the premiere.
Absolutely. Hey, we have it. We have all the makeup ready to go on it. It's screened. Well, God bless, and the devilonwheelsmovie.com, and we will be in touch as soon as we get some more information and find out how your money total is.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having us.
Thanks.
Appreciate you guys. Thank you.
Thank you.
We also want to go back and thank Roger and everybody in your team at the Devil on Wheels movie. We cannot wait to watch this. They're trying to get everything together right now. We don't know where it's going to be distributed right now yet, November the 13th, but we got information coming soon. So you guys, thank you so much for what you guys have done, and it was a blast talking to you tonight and honoring the 50th anniversary, and we hope that everyone gets to see the Devil on Wheels.
And let's see what happens with this truck for the next 50 years.
Yeah, exactly. In fact, Brad's got a bottle of champagne that we're gonna probably christen it and do a little
sip. And begin the next 50 years.
Thank you, Moxie. Thank you, Overdrive Magazine, for posting this on the anniversary of Duel, 50 years into the future. And that is what we call a wrap.
Thank you.